Welcome back. The crack stopped working and we're going to be showing you the latest version on how to do it in 2025. So if you have like your normal cursor ID, I think it updates automatically, and you would see that once you have the latest updates, your ID would stop working and you could be having this issue, right? If you're having this issue, this is how to fix it in 2025. First and first, navigate to the site that we found and click this, right? It pops up. Just close all the annoying ads and you can follow the instructions. Now, in this video, I'll be showing you how to do this for Windows, right? I've tested this with Windows, and you can test it with Mac. If it works for you, please specify that it's working for you in Mac. If it works for you in Linux, also specify. Also, even if it works for you in Windows, please specify so that when it stops working, we know. And please remember the last time, once it's no longer working, you guys will just say not working. What do you mean by not working? Like, what OS, you know? Like, how did it not work? Were you still getting the error, or the error changed or something, you know? When you're leaving those comments, please kind of provide details for us so we kind of have an idea on why it's not working. Okay, so but I'm going to show you this for Windows. I have not tried this with Mac or Linux. You guys will have to be the one to do that test, right? So for Windows, it says you need to totally uninstall cursor from your system, right? To completely install the cursor, right, I think you should close the platform, right? Close, and then you go to your settings and look for the cursor ID. Right now I have version 0.457 installed. Take note of this, right? You have to look for it and you uninstall it, right? Uninstall, and it's going to be uninstalled from your system, right? So if you come and search for it again, you will not be able to find it. So once it's completely uninstalled from your system, you now need to delete these folders, right? So let me show you that. So you have to open your File Explorer and navigate, right? And if you're able to navigate, you need to take a step backward. So I want to go backward to app data, right? So that way you're not inside the folder. Yeah, so this way you can click on cursor and delete. Right, this is completely. Then next you have to go to local, right? This is local here, right? You would see a folder, the updater, right? You have to delete this guy too, right? And next you have to go to programs, inside programs you see this, and you need to also delete that. Now if you notice, if you can't find any of this folder, like for Windows users, if you can't find any of this folder, then that means it has been deleted. It's fine, you can move forward. But for other OS, you have to locate where they are and make sure you delete them. So once that is done, right, the next thing we need to do is download the cursor AI. This URL is not this download is not from Mercy Axe. It's actually the cursor site directly. So I will copy the URL so you can see what I'm saying. Copy link, right, and paste. Can you see what the URL is? Right, you need to download this specific version of cursor. So when you click on it, you can see this is the specific version 0.44.11, right? Anything above this is not going to work, right? So you need to download this version of cursor AI, and then you need to install it when you're done. So I would just double click so it can install. So it's installing it, right? The installation might take some seconds, right? And you see mine is done installing here, right? And when it installs, sorry, let me drag it into this window. You get this page. It says after installation, what else should we do? Okay, install the specific version, right? Then we need to create an account with temp mail. So let's open that. After the account, we need to log in with the account. Okay. So, to come back here, we will just, click on continue. Use the extension, right? Like you installed it normally. Continue with the default privacy mode. Continue, and then now you need to sign up. So when you click on sign up, if this page is not loading for you, right like this, you need a VPN, means it's not available in your country. So you click on quick connect, like with your VPN, you can check this out to be able to use this. And then when you refresh, I turned on my VPN now. You can see this actually loads, right? So personally, I created a temp mail account. I'm not sure. Okay, you know what? This video is supposed to be showing everything raw. I'm already logged in, right? So, but let me just show in case, like, let's say you're not logged in and you need a brand new account and whatnot. So you would come here, right, and click on sign in. Right, create sign up. Then let's go to the temp mail account just to make sure, like, you get right. Funny enough, temp mail is still giving me the exact same accounts from yes that I used earlier. No problem. But normally you would come here and you will set it up, right? But since I already have an account, let's just I already set up this account yesterday, right? So let's just sign in and go ahead with that. But I think we all know how to proceed if you understand me, right? If you need to sign up, so you sign up with the Temp Mail account, sign in with that. I am human. Yes, I'm just a broke human. Okay, now that I'm signing, you can see, like I said, I did this like I think yesterday, and it's a free trial account, right? You can see all the details here, right? It's the free trial account. So when you come back here, you click on login, it brings you here and it takes you back. Yes, login. So I am all set and now we can test this. Hi. Okay, one thing is missing. Sorry, so after doing this, right, why this account is like this, I need to change I need to change this. So it says after we log in, right, when you see, so after we create login temporary account, we're still going to get this info, right? That's when we now do this part we usually do before. So now you're going to navigate to this URL for Windows. Like I said, for Mac users, you can try yourself. For let's navigate to the URL, and it's just a file, so it opens with Camina, and so now we're going to be getting the key from Messy Hacks, right? And copy. Okay, yeah, thank you. So you copy, Sorry, before I copy, you need to close this. Sorry, I'm a bit under the weather. I'm mixing up the steps, but just stay with me. Once you close that, right, let's close this and open this again. This one, enter. Right? And we are met with here. And now you need to replace the four keys. So I'm replacing this with this. This with the same key. The same key. The same key. All four of them. Right? And it's VS Code, so it automatically saves. I close this, right? And yeah, create a backup, okay? Before you start this. I close this and I did this, and now I can restart cursor, right? So when I open cursor again, let's try sending a message. Hi. Right. And that's it. And that's how you're doing, right? So what, like, let's go through the steps together again. Okay. You can see it's working now. I'm still using the trial account. This account. Right. I'm still using the trial account, right? Upgrade to Pro is still here and all that. You can see it's a new account I created yesterday. Now, let's go through the steps again. What and what did I do? First things first, we uninstalled Cursor, right? We deleted all these folders, right? They are folders, not files. We deleted all these folders. Then we downloaded this specific Cursor version from Cursor, not Messiac actually, just giving you a link to it from Cursor. And we created a new account using temp mail, which I already did before, but like, you know what I mean, right? I did one earlier, but you can create a new one. We logged in with that temporary account. Then we started getting this error, right? The errors everybody saw. We started getting this error again. Then we navigated to this location, and then we were able to edit this contact based on what was given to us on Messiah site, right? We saved the file, we reset cursor, and now we're able to send messages with the pro model cloud 3.5 sorted, right? We're able to send messages with pro model, which we were unable to do before because we'll be getting the too many free trials error. I think so. That just shows you guys like how it works. There is a source of a repo in case you're having issues with Linux or Mac. You can debug and investigate further there. All right, thank you. Sorry for it being a long video, but I've been warned that my videos are too fast and short, like it's hard for people to follow, so I'm like experimenting a bit. Thank you all for tuning in, and please 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 do subscribe. That is the truth, because last time we did this, about 20k views, only 500 people subscribe, which I really do appreciate all of you do subscribed. And when it stopped working, now everybody knew the road to my DM, everybody was sending mails and the rest. So please subscribe so that you get the latest information, you get the latest news, right? Because at the end, we can't keep posting this on YouTube. We would have to like create a community of sort. So subscribe for a, subscribe to get stay ahead of the latest updates. Thank you, everybody. Bye.